For the Army of the near future, top leaders want their force to be harder to see and harder to hear. How do you do that with a 10-ton truck with a chugging muffler or a 27-ton Bradley with a bright heat signature? Make it electric, of course. The Army envisions electrifying its non-tactical trucks first, and eventually its combat vehicles, and the defense industry already has plenty of options to pitch. We took a look at some of the models on offer at the recent AUSA conference here in Washington, D.C. First up, General Dynamics Abrams X, the company's new hybrid tank that it says can achieve the same tactical range as the regular Abrams, but with half the fuel and a smaller engine. Designed to operate silently at low speeds, the GD Land Systems demonstrator was on display at AUSA last week, right next to another potential hybrid system, the Stryker X. Along with requiring a smaller crew, the hybrid electric Abrams is lighter than the current tank, helping with that fuel economy, and easier to maintain as well. They're going to need a lot of power, though. Both of the GDLS vehicles are set to be loaded with sensors and sophisticated systems like multi-domain information processing. This makes development of the battery half of the hybrid electric drive system all the more important. Also on the floor at AUSA was GM Defense's all-electric infantry squad vehicle. Leveraging General Motors' commercial market work on EVs to help advance the design, the company completely removed the combustion engine from the vehicle and made it fully electric. Silent and far-ranging, the development of the fully electric ISV is still an internal effort, but company president Steve Dumont said the switch to an all-electric Army fleet is something he sees as inevitable. Another entry in the electric hybrid category is BAE Systems' Bradley fighting vehicle. Able to operate in silent mode for up to 6 hours, BAE's Bradley is well into the prototyping phase, with two already delivered to the Army for testing. BAE actually has a scalable hybrid system that can fit into vehicles from 30 to 60 tons, which means the same design can be used in the whole portfolio of Army vehicles short of the main battle tank. So the Army may be headed electric, but being untethered from fuel supply doesn't mean you don't still need power. So how do you get charged up on the front lines? One solution is PlusOn North America's all-terrain electric mission module, basically a robotic electricity mule that could replace towed gas-powered generators. The module could push conventionally powered trucks and turn them into an ad hoc hybrid, and it gives them the silent watch capability. It could recharge fully electric vehicles in the field, and it could even serve as a remote-controlled platform hauling sensors and weapons without ever needing a driver. As the Army looks to an early 2027 deadline to buy electric versions of its non-tactical vehicles, and a 2050 deadline for a fully electric fleet, industry is already testing a range of engines and enablers to get the Army there.